The clock, the counter, is based on the Obama White House administration's Council of Economic Advisors estimates that retirement savers lose $17 billion a year because of conflicts of interest. But that figure is extremely conservative. It looked only at a part of the market, namely mutual funds, broker-sold mutual funds, and variable annuities inside IRAs. So it didn't include a whole host of products that are marketed and sold to retirement savers based on conflicts of interest and that result in harm to retirement savers, such as fixed index annuities, which are regulated as insurance. They're not regulated as securities. And non-traded REITs. It also didn't include the costs of conflicts based on 401k advice. When somebody has an opportunity to invest in a better alternative in their 401k, but they get recommended an inferior alternative in their 401k, it didn't include those costs. And Mr. Wingate's experience is a prime example of the harm that can result outside of the estimates that the White House estimated. Non-traded REITs are rife with conflicts of interest. They lock up retirement savers' nest eggs for years. They have exorbitant costs, all because they pay the manufacturer of the non-traded REIT and the person recommending the non-traded REIT a lot of money. It's very profitable for them, but it comes at the retirement saver's expense. A recent study estimated that investors have lost an approximate $45 billion over the last 25 years because they were peddled into these improper products. The reason that the White House estimate focused on the area of the market that it did is not because that's where the harm is the greatest. It's because that's where the evidence is the clearest. It is the area of the market where it's most transparent as far as the compensation arrangements, as far as the conflicts of interest, and as far as the resulting underperformance of these products. But if you look in the more opaque, complex part of the market, the harm is much worse. So we need the rule, we need the protections of the rule to be in place to stem the losses that retirement savers are facing. You know, it's terribly unfortunate that President Trump decided to throw a monkey wrench into this process by calling for a reexamination of this rule and that the DOL delayed the rule's implementation. Because in the months leading up to the rule's implementation, we were seeing a lot of progress in the market. Firms were showing that they were coming into compliance, and we were seeing the benefits of the rule take effect. For example, products and advice, the costs were coming down. Conflicts were being wrung out of advisors' business models, and investors were being assured that they were going to get a variety of products and services, but never have to give up their right to receive best interest advice. Unfortunately, President Trump's statement threw a monkey wrench into this process, and now it's uncertain whether these benefits are going to stick. And one example is in the development of new share classes in mutual funds. In the months leading up to the presidential memorandum, mutual fund manufacturers had stated that they were going to lower the cost of these products by more than half. These were immediate savings that retirement savers were going to see because of the rule. Unfortunately, when he made the announcement, the mutual fund manufacturers pulled back and they stalled the efforts at developing these funds. And so come April 10th, next week, retirement savers aren't going to have access to these lower cost products. They're going to be forced to pay the higher costs based on for these products, which is unfortunate. We need the rule to be implemented without any delay. Retirement savers need, expect, and deserve the protections of the rule, and we won't stop the clock until they have a meaningful, enforceable best interest standard. Thank you.